So this is the MERC50 from Magnum. Got this hooked up to the MM1212. And this remote can actually do a little more than my inverter can do. It's set up to work with almost every inverter that Magnum makes. Probably every inverter that Magnum makes. And just a couple interesting things. When you first get started, the main thing you're going to want to play around with is the setup. And so on the setup, oops, here we go. We go through, we hit the setup button, and we got search watts. So let's go ahead and hit select. That's in on this rotary knob here. So I've got it set at 5 watts. And basically that means that the inverter's not going to wake up from sleep mode unless it feels a pull of 5 watts to kind of avoid the inverter just being on all the time. If we go back through, you can go and check out the low battery cutout. Hit that. Absorb charging. Low battery cutout, 11.8 volts DC. I have that set up so that we can't go through and discharge the battery bank too deep that we end up damaging it. Learning how to use this kind of stuff is going to be really helpful if you're not wanting to buy batteries every year. Here's where we can set the battery amp hours and the battery type. This is going to determine what kind of battery we're looking at. These UPGs are an AGM type 2, but we could also see if we had a flooded. There's actually a setting for gel. That just means that you're going to get a little bit lower amperage coming in. The gels can't really take as much current without bubbling and getting all out of control here. So we've got that AGM type 2. I'm going to keep going. VAC dropout, power save, screen contrast. So we missed the thing I wanted to see. Charge rate. Here we go. So we can jump in here and see the max charge rate set at 80%. Means we're looking at like 80% of the charger's capacity. Going in here, kick it up a little bit. See what happens if we kick it to 100. Nothing. Fabulous. And that's pretty much it as far as the setup. You can just get in and get going on the running light bulbs and doing that kind of stuff. Set ours at 80 here. One thing I have a couple issues with as far as troubleshooting goes, you can see we've got two different buttons here. Here's the on-off for the charger. Here's the on-off for the inverter. See, the inverter's turn the on position. Just turn that off. See, we're in absorb charging, 14.8 volts, 34 amps. These batteries have been needing to charge for a while, but they're going to have to wait a little bit, because we'll want to jump inside and check out the inside of this midnight e-panel.